So we studied two kinds of immunity. One is when pathogen binds to PRR, it shows PTI immunity, and another is when effector binds to the LRR proteins, it causes effector triggered immunity. So this effector triggered immunity, it shows hypersensitive response. Okay, so hypersensitive response is seen in effector triggered immunity. So what happens here? So when a plant is infected by insects or any pathogenic microorganisms, it responds to those challenges. How it responds? It shows the alteration in the chemical properties of the cell wall. Okay, so cell wall properties is changed when a plant shows or encounters any pathogen attack. The cell wall properties are altered. Then what we see that there is a synthesis of secondary metabolites. Now these kind of response when a plant shows after pathogenic attack, this is known as hypersensitive response. Okay, now due to this hypersensitive response, what can plant do? They can isolate themselves. They can isolate the other cells from the infected cells. They also limit these cells for the further spread. Okay, so see, if in this plant one part or one area of the leaf is infected, if one area of the leaf is infected here, what plant will do? The plant will immediately show the hypersensitive response, so that they'll isolate the other cells in this region from the infected cells, and they will not allow these cells to infect further. So what they do? They will not allow the nutrient to move to this region. They will not allow the nutrient from the other parts of the plant to move to this region. So the pathogen residing in this region will be deprived of nutrients and they will not grow further. Okay, so ultimately what will happen? The pathogen in this lesion will die because they are deprived of nutrient. Okay, so pathogen when dies here, there will be no further spread. So whenever the hypersensitive response is successful, okay, what will happen? A small region of dead tissue, a small region of a dead tissue is left at the site of the invasion, but rest of the region is unaffected. Okay, so small lesion remains at the site of infection, but rest of the tissue is unaffected due to the several responses seen by the several responses which occur in hypersensitive response. Okay. Now what we saw that after the hypersensitive response, there is a formation of reactive oxygen species. And formation of this reactive oxygen species in large amount is known as oxidative burst. So there are several reactive oxygen species are formed at the site of infection by the reduction of molecular oxygen. So like superoxide anion, hydrogen peroxide, hydroxyl radical, and among these, this hydroxyl radical is the strongest oxidant. So what is the role of ROS, reactive oxygen species, forming at the site of infection? They help in lipid peroxidation, enzyme inactivation, and nucleic acid degradation at the site of infection, due to which the infection area cannot grow any further. Okay. Now one role was that to limit the spread of the pathogen. वन रोल ऑफ रॉस वॉज टू लिमिट द स्प्रेड ऑफ द पैथोजन. अनदर इज इट हेल्प्स इन द मॉडिफिकेशन ऑफ सेल वॉल प्रोटीन्स. हाउ? बाय द डिपोजिशन ऑफ लिग्निन एंड कैलोज. ओके, सो हियर इट विल बी प्रॉपर्टीज. By the deposition of lignin and callose, okay, with which the infection is not spread further. So if this is a plant cell, so what we see that here in the cell wall region there will be the deposition of lignin and callose, due to which the cell wall becomes more hardened and the pathogen cannot spread to another cell. Okay, so what happens, it helps in the deposition of lignin and callose, and also they helps in the deposition of lignin and callose in the plasmodesmatal cells also, so that there will be the connection between the cell to cell will be lost for the meantime. Now this ROS also helps in the cross linking of the proline rich proteins. Okay, so proline rich proteins becomes oxidatively cross linked in response to H2O2, which is a ROS, due to which the wall is even strengthened even more at the infection site. Okay, which further increases the resistance to the microbial digestion. So what is this lignin and callose are doing? They are acting as a barrier. Okay, they are blocking the spread of the pathogen. Till now we have studied that this hypersensitive response causes the formation of ROS, and ROS also causes the increase, or ROS also causes the modification of cell wall proteins. Now this HR response, hypersensitive response, they also activates. Now HR seems like the HR person, the person who manages everything. So they activate ROS also, like they have to look after several things. They activate ROS also, they activate phytoalexins also. Instead they synthesizes phytoalexins, they synthesizes chitinases. Now what these are? So phytoalexins are specific kind of chemicals. So chemicals, what is the nature of these chemicals? That they are isoflavones. Isoflavones we already studied when we were doing secondary metabolite. Okay, so the nature of phytoalexins are, they are isoflavones, they are produced in response to microbial attack. So HR response helps in synthesis of phytoalexins and chitinases, and they degrade the cell wall of the fungus. Okay, what they are? So they are under a group of proteins, these phytoalexins and chitinases. They are chitinases, as the name says, it destroys the chitin structure of the fungus. Chitin is a composition of the cell wall of fungus, and chitinases breaks down this chitin of fungus. Now these phytoalexins and chitinases, they are a group of proteins named PR proteins. So what we studied, hypersensitive response activate ROS also, they activate phytoalexins, and instead of phytoalexins and this, I'll write that they activate PR proteins. So what are PR proteins? PR proteins include chitinases and phytoalexins. ओके. नाउ वी विल स्टडी अबाउट फाइटोएलेक्जेंस इन डिटेल. नाउ फाइटोएलेक्जेंस आर व्हाट? दे आर आइसोफ्लेवोनॉइड्स. These phytoalexins are produced in response to microbial attack by the plant and they are produced at the site of infection. So when the infection has not occurred, they are undetectable in the plant and are synthesized very rapidly after the microbial attack. Now how they are synthesized so rapidly? Because there is activation of some biosynthetic pathways which make them activated. So these phytoalexins are found in several family of plants including legume family and so the nature of phytoalexins produced by different plants is different. Okay, so some plant produces phytoalexins. So isoflavones, phytoalexins are produced by legume family of plants. Okay, and sesquiterpenes are produced. Sesquiterpenes, nature of phytoalexins are produced by potato, tobacco, or potato family of plants, say for example Solanaceae. So Solanaceae family of plants, they activate phytoalexins and nature of that phytoalexin is sesquiterpene, and legume family of plant activates phytoalexins and the nature is isoflavones. Clear? Now we will study about the effector molecules. So we studied that ETI immunity. We studied till now, we are studying like from the very beginning, we are studying ETI immunity only, where the hypersensitive response occurred. Okay, now what happens? These elicitors or effector molecules, when they take entry inside the cell, they are recognized by LRR proteins. These LRR proteins activates R genes. So these R genes function in defense against fungi, bacteria and nematodes. So these R genes, specific pathogen molecules are recognized to as elicitors, and these elicitors can be of variety of types. They can be proteins, peptides, sterols, polysaccharide fragments which are arising from the pathogen cell wall or outer membrane or a secretion process. So through a several process or through any kind of process, these elicitors molecules are released by pathogen which are recognized by R genes. Okay, so there are several kind of R genes found in plants. 20 different plant resistance genes known as R genes, they function against the defense. They function as a defense against fungi, bacteria, nematodes. So these R genes products themselves are nearly all proteins. So R genes have a nature that they have LRR repeats. Very important. Question comes from this topic. This R gene have LRR repeats. LRR stands for leucine rich repeats. Now these leucine rich repeats are repeated several times in the amino acid sequence of R gene. Now what happens? The R genes encode a nucleotide binding site called ATP or GTP, and they also encode protein kinase domain. This is the structure of R gene. And this LRR region of R gene is responsible for pathogen binding. Okay. Now R gene when binds to elicitor, there is a signaling cascade which occurs. What signaling cascade? So fragments of the pathogen molecule when called as elicitors. So elicitors can be a variety of types. So say for example, when fragment of pathogen molecules, they are when bound to R gene, what happens? It leads to the signaling cascade. Okay, so they are when injected directly into the cell, they interact with the R gene product. This R gene when activated, they causes the change in ion flux, we already studied. Okay, OH minus and K plus efflux and Ca2 plus and H plus influx. This also causes the oxidation and formation of ROS. So ROS are formed, ion flux occurred. ROS causes cell wall cross-linking. Now due to these all responses, what happens? There will be hypersensitive response, phytoalexin biosynthesis, lignin biosynthesis. Now I'll come to this salicylic biosynthesis. I'll teach just now, which will, the salicylic acid will cause systemic acquired resistance, in short SAR. Biosynthesis of some hydrolytic enzymes, okay, which will not allow the pathogen to invade further. Now changes in ion flux, I already told, when there will be the signaling cascade, when it occurs, when LRR proteins becomes activated, there will be the change in ion flux. Ca2 plus and H plus will enter into the cell, and K plus and Cl minus exits the cell. This influx of Ca2 plus, it causes the oxidative burst. Okay, we already studied what oxidative burst will, how it will help the plant to show the defense response. Now, it was shown that when this Ca2 plus channels were blocked, okay, then the defense response was inhibited. So when Ca2 plus uptake was stimulated, the defense response were activated. Okay, the experiment was done with Ca2 plus ionophores, which will allow more and more Ca2 plus to take entry inside the cell. Okay, so it will be inhibited when Ca2 plus channels are blocked. It will be activated when Ca2 plus channels are open. So what if this HR response fails? There should be another pathway which will complement. So what will happen? It will activate the hormonal signaling pathway. Some hormones will be activated if HR response fails. Okay? So what will be the role of these hormones? Ultimately, what HR were doing? Ultimately, HR were doing that they were activating the PR proteins. That these HR were activating the PR proteins. Now these hormonal pathway, what they will do? They will also activate the PR proteins, but through a different mechanism. Okay, so starting with the first hormonal pathway, salicylic acid mediated response. So what happened? There are some secondary metabolites which are associated with hypersensitive reaction. What we studied till now, that there are some secondary metabolites which are associated with hypersensitive response, and they appear to constitute a signal transduction pathway. So this HR response, they cause a signal transduction pathway that will prepare the other cells and tissues to resist the secondary infection or the second time infection. So it is not necessary that when HR response will fail, then only hormonal signaling pathway will be activated. This is not true. Okay, so this HR response is like the response in a region where the infection occurred. But when the plant wants to protect the whole plant, okay, when a plant wants to protect the whole plant to resist the plant from infection for the second time, then there will be again a signaling cascade which will be activated. So what will happen? So initially this hypersensitive response which occurred, they were limited to few cells only initially in the few minutes. Limited to few cells at the point of invasion. But after a period of time, what will happen? Like after a period of time from hours to days, it may take from hours to days. What will happen? They increase their capacity to resist the pathogen attack. Okay? What they will do, they'll activate a signaling cascade which will help the whole plant to resist the pathogen attack. Okay? The whole plant will be now protected from the pathogen attack. And how they are activated? That there will be signaling molecule which will be distributed to whole the whole of the plant, and the whole plant now becomes protected from the infection. So this kind of defense response is known as systemic acquired response, and this systemic acquired response is through a chemical intermediate known as salicylic acid. Okay, so this is systemic acquired response. So after the hypersensitive response, it may take few hours to days to form a systemic acquired resistance, which will make the whole plant protected from the secondary infection. So what will happen? A single encounter with a pathogen may increase resistance to future attacks. They remain themselves aware of the future attack. So they want themselves to be prepared for the future attack. So to be prepared for the future attack, when there is first time infection, what happens? There is a synthesis of molecule known as salicylic acid. So after a first time infection, salicylic acid will be synthesized, which will be distributed to whole plant. So now the whole plant, when it has salicylic acid, it is prepared for the second time infection. Okay? So when a plant survives the infection of a pathogen at one site, it often develops increased resistance to subsequent attacks at sites throughout the plant, and it enjoys the protection against a wide range of pathogen species. Now this salicylic acid which will help them to protect against a wide range of species. Now this phenomena is known as systemic acquired resistance. It takes few hours to days to develop the SAR response. So after the initial response, it takes few hours to days to develop the SAR response. Now what this systemic acquired resistance will do? It will increase the level of certain defense compounds including chitinases and hydrolytic enzymes. And one of the signal molecule here is salicylic acid. So this SAR is what it is doing. It is also activating the chitinases, which are PR proteins, and some hydrolytic enzymes which hydrolyzes the cell wall of the pathogen. So they are again the group of PR protein. Now what happens? So this benzoic acid derivative, which is salicylic acid, they will rise dramatically in the zone of infection after the initial attack. Okay? And this is thought to establish a SAR in all other parts of the plant. So inside the initial infection, so here when the infection occurred, okay, after First, it will be hypersensitive response, immediate response. Now, in the site of infection, there will be SAR response, which will take few hours, 2 days to develop this SAR response. Once this SAR response is activated, SAR response is activated means once this salicylic acid molecules are synthesized here. Okay, what will happen? These salicylic acid molecules the red colored ones, they'll be moved throughout the plant. Okay, they'll move throughout the plant so that this whole plant is now resistant to this particular infection. Okay, and in this way they can protect the plant from wide range of infections. Now this salicylic acid is itself not a mobile signal which moves. I told the salicylic acid moved, but actually this is not the signal which moves. The ester, methyl ester of salicylic acid, which is methyl salicylate, it is a volatile SAR. Please very remember this topic, salicylic acid topic is very important. It acts as a volatile SAR which is transmitted to distant parts of the plant and even to the neighboring plant so that they will also become resistant. So this way what we see that even though plants lack immune systems like in animals, they have elaborate mechanisms to protect themselves from the disease causing microbes. So see these phytoalexins examples, medicarpin, glycolin, ricin, capsidol, like the names are not important, just to show that they have antimicrobial properties and they are rapidly synthesized after the microbial infection. They are the part of hypersensitive response. So look at this. So what we see in this picture that even when one leaf is infected, the whole plant can become resistant to that particular infection. So the lesson is when here, see, there is a synthesis of methyl salicylate and salicylic acid in this region. From the in the infected leaf, there will be synthesis of salicylic acid and methyl salicylate. Now this salicylic acid is not mobile. They will be transmitted through the vascular system, resulting in SAR response. Now this methyl salicylate are volatile, which are the actual mediators of SAR. They are volatile and through airborne transmission they transmit the signal to other parts of the plant and also to the neighboring plants, that is the plants in that area. So in that way they give the resistance to the plant, to resistance to the whole plant as well as to the neighboring plants. So it was seen that salicylic acid and its acetyl derivative aspirin, they are when applied to tobacco plants, they activate PR gene expression. Okay, so salicylic acid are increased both locally, that like in the plant where they are produced, or in the region where they are produced, and in the distal region of the plant. So even where they are not produced, they are distributed to that region of the plant also. Okay, so this is a main molecule which is produced in the SAR response. So see, the commercial derivative of salicylic acid is acetyl salicylic acid or aspirin. So salicylic acid has been implicated in the immune strategies of the plant, we already discussed. Now bacteria, some bacteria have NAHG gene, okay, which encodes the enzyme. So NAHG gene encodes the enzyme salicylate hydroxylase, ओके विच विल हाइड्रोक्सिलेट सैलिसाइलेट एंड विल रेंडर सैलिसिलिक एसिड इनएक्टिव. ओके सो व्हाट विल हैपन व्हेन Arabidopsis plants are transformed with those bacteria which have this NAHG gene. It was found that these bacteria, it was found that those plants will have little or no salicylic acid. Okay, so those plants will have little or no salicylic acid. Then what we see, the plants transformed with NAHG gene also failed to establish SAR. So it was seen that whenever NAHG gene was present, SAR response cannot be established. So here Arabidopsis previously did not have the NAHG gene, but when it was transformed with bacteria having NAHG gene, so in the plant NAHG gene came, so because of which there will be no salicylic acid formation. Okay, so whenever a plant will have NAHG gene, then there will be no SAR response. Salicylic acid levels can also be reduced by direct inhibition of enzyme PAL. Okay, so there is a first step in the biosynthesis of salicylic acid which requires the enzyme PAL. So if PAL is inhibited, okay, then the salicylic acid levels drop down because they cannot be synthesized further. So PAL is required for salicylic acid synthesis. When this enzyme is inhibited, the salicylic acid synthesis will be inhibited. So when a plant will not have PAL, their resistance will be lost. But when salicylic acid is applied again, when there will be external application of salicylic acid, they restore their ability for resistance. So, conclusion is the salicylic acid has a significant role in plant defense responses. They have a significant role in developing systemic acquired resistance. Now, another gene named as NPR1 gene. Okay, this is also very important because question comes from this topic. Now the full form is non-expressor of pathogenesis related gene. So what happens? This NPR1 gene, when there is no pathogen attack, they are expressed at very low level in the plant. But when there is the salicylic acid treatment, okay, when there is salicylic acid treatment, then there will be the increase in the mRNA synthesis of NPR gene. So what does this NPR gene do? It interacts with many transcription factors, and these transcription factors are from TGA family of transcription factors. Okay, so when they interact with transcription factors, what will happen? When these NPR proteins, when they interact with transcription factors, what will happen? They stimulate the activation of PR genes. So PR genes, you already know, chitinases, hydroxylases. So what happens is actually that this reactive oxygen species, okay, when there is a burst of oxygen species, this reactive oxygen species to a reducing environment is formed by salicylic acid. So back to the reducing environment again, it is by salicylic acid. Okay, and this appears to facilitate the transcription of PR genes. So this salicylic acid, what it is doing, it is triggering the NPR gene which is initially residing in the cytosol. It allows the translocation of NPR1 gene to nucleus. In the nucleus, what will happen? It will interact with TGA transcription factors and ultimately activating PR proteins. Okay. So what we see in this picture, that pathogen will activate HR response, which will activate salicylic acid. The salicylic acid will be moved through the vascular system to the another region. Okay, so either in the methyl salicylate form, which is through the airborne spread, or through salicylic acid, which is through the vascular system. So this is primary infection and this is secondary infection. So primary infection, when pathogen attacks, then HR response was activated, and secondary response is salicylic acid is already there, so pathogen cannot attack. So the first time infection occurred is known as primary infection, which activates the HR response, and salicylic acid will be synthesized, which is then translocated through the phloem to the other regions, causing and preventing the secondary infection. Salicylic acid can be converted to methyl salicylic acid. Now MSA, which is methyl salicylic acid, is moderately volatile and can function as airborne signal.